the Ghana Empire of Africa. When discussing the Empire of the Ghanaians, one of the things we need to keep in mind is that much of what we know has come from legends or has been passed down orally. In other words, giving specific dates and loads of factual tidbits can be a bit difficult. For this reason, we're going to stick to generally accepted things about the way of life and their rule. Iron smelting. For starters, legend holds that the Kingdom of Ghana was established sometime around the year 200 to 300 CE. However, it didn't really begin to take off until about the year 350 CE, when the Ghanaian people learned the art of iron smelting. For those of us unfamiliar with this term, iron smelting is the act of melting down raw iron in order to extract metal. Using smelting to make iron swords, Ghanaian warriors were able to conquer the people around them and spread the boundaries of their rule to include much of the Western Sudan by about the year 830 CE. Wealth and trade. With this surge of power, the Ghana Empire took control of West Africa's major trade routes, which carried salt and gold throughout the region and even into Asia and Europe. Of course, this, along with iron welding warriors, made the kingdom extremely powerful and wealthy. In fact, the name Ghana actually means warrior king or king of gold. Speaking of kings, the Ghanaian kings were very, very adept to using the trade routes to turn a profit. Tradition tells us that the Ghanaian kings taxed all goods that entered Ghana. This made the king so wealthy that legend holds that all the gold nuggets in the land belonged to him, while everyone else had to settle for trading dust gold. One tale even speaks of the Ghanaian king using huge piece of gold as the hitching post for his horses. Taxation and decline. Adding to the wealth of the king and his empire wasn't just goods that got taxed, sort of like our modern day toll roads. Any merchant that entered the kingdom had to pay a fee just to get in, and they had to turn around and pay another fee to leave. Although it sounds a bit lopsided, history tells us it was sort of win-win for both the Ghanaian rulers and the traveling merchants, since the king smartly used the fees to fund the armies there. With their healthy budget, of course, the army then made sure Ghana was a safe place to travel and do business. With this setup, the gold and the salt of the empire was not just traded regionally, it also made its way to places like Europe. Sadly for the people of Ghana Empire, as their goods were shipped to other parts of the world, and other parts of the world became very interested in getting their hands on the region. In other words, outsiders started thinking, why settle for a little bit of gold when we can conquer them and have it all? As these outside forces began to bear down on the empire, it began to weaken. Finally, in 135 CE, the Kingdom of Ghana and its wealth fell to Arab invaders from the north. With this, the once mighty warrior kings of Ghana were reduced to pawns in a war for the wealthy lands of West Africa that would last for generations to come. Lesson summary. The Ghana Empire of Africa was a trading empire that ruled in West Africa from 1830 to 125-30 CE. It used iron smelting, the act of melting down raw iron in order to extract metal to produce iron swords, which allowed its warriors to conquer much of the Western Sudan. With its military power, the Ghana Empire ruled over trading routes of Western Africa. These routes saw gold, salt, and many other goods shipped from Africa to places as far as Europe and Asia. Due to this, the Kingdom of Ghana became very wealthy, with the name Ghana carrying twofold meaning: warrior king and king of gold. So wealthy and powerful was the empire that it actually takes mentions just for entering and leaving its country. Unfortunately, as the Ghanaian people traded with the outside world became interested in conquering its wealthy lands. With this, the wealthy empire of Ghana fell to the northern Arab invaders around the year 120-35 CE. Thank you very much for watching, and see you on the next lesson.